Dear students, now we are going to discuss about reciprocity theorem with its proof.
Reciprocity principle or reciprocity theorem states that an antenna can be used as either transmitting antenna or receiving antenna. Hence, the directional patterns, directivities and terminal impedances are same for both transmitting and receiving side. Here, we are going to prove this property, the statement, with the diagram. Here, consider two antennas, antenna 1, antenna 2. In this diagram, we are going to give the input to this antenna 1. So, antenna 1 is used as a transmitting antenna, which is transmitting the energy flow from antenna 1 to antenna 2. So, in this diagram, the antenna 1 is used as a receiving antenna. Here we are going to give the input at the second antenna. The same antenna 1 can be used as a transmitting as well as receiving. If I am going to give the current to the transmitting antenna, then the current I1 induces an EMF in the second antenna, that is represented as E21. In some other books, they have represented V21, that is induced voltage. Okay, so this is first scenario. So in this scenario, if I am going to give the input at the second antenna, then the current I2 induces an EMF in the first antenna as E12. That means here this value represents first port to second, that is first antenna to the second antenna. Here it is E12, that means second antenna to first antenna. Okay, so according to reciprocity theorem, the induced EMF from first antenna to the second antenna is equal to the induced EMF from second antenna to the first antenna, provided the currents are equal, that is I1 is equal to I2. Here we are going to assume that the medium between the antennas are linear, passive and isotropic. The key point in this reciprocity theorem is the transmitting and receiving properties of an antenna are identical. That is, for the same antenna, the transmitting properties as well as the receiving properties, both are same. Now we are going to prove this reciprocity theorem. So here we are going to consider the space between the antennas as the T network. Okay, so to prove the reciprocity theorem for antennas, the space between the antennas are replaced by a network of linear, passive and bilateral impedances. So here we can consider this case. We are going to give the input at the first antenna, that is I1. Here Z11 is nothing but the self impedance of the antenna 1. Here the second antenna is open 1. Z22 is nothing but self impedance of the second antenna. Zm is the mutual impedance between the two antennas. Now we are going to apply Kirchhoff's mesh law for each loops. So here, because of this current I1, that induced EMF is E21 in this second antenna. Okay. So now we are going to apply Kirchhoff's mesh law in this first loop. So we can get, that is Z11 plus Zm into I1, that is minus by Zm into I2. Here that current is what? I2. Correct. So here we can write it like this. From this first loop, Z11 plus Zm into I1. Because I1 is flowing from this input side to this side. So Z11 plus Zm into I1 minus, because the current in the opposite direction. So minus Zm into I2 is equal to 0. Because there is no induced EMF.
EMF is present in the second antenna, there is no voltage source. So here it is 0. So that is the first equation. So consider the second loop here. So in the second loop, again, Z, the same thing. Okay, Z22 plus ZM into I2. Okay, minus ZM into I1. That is equal to the voltage is present E21. Do you all understand? Now we have got two equations. So from this first equation, we can obtain the value of I1. So here it is 0. So we can move this value to this right hand side as plus. So Z11 plus Zm into I1 is equal to Zm into I2. So from this we can get I1 value. I1 is equal to Zm I2 divided by Z11 plus Zm. Zm is nothing but mutual impedance. Okay, consider this as the third equation. So next we are going to substitute this third equation in the second equation. So here in the second equation we are having I1. This I1 is replaced by Zm I2 divided by Z11 plus Zm. So now we can get Z22 plus Zm I2 minus Zm of that I1 is replaced with the third equation, right? So Zm I2 by Z11 plus Zm, that is equal to E21. Next we are going to multiply this. We can get Zm squared I2 divided by Z11 plus Zm. Then we have to take the LCM. So here we are going to multiply this term with Z11 plus Zm. So we can get Z11 plus Zm into Z22 plus Zm I2 minus Zm squared into I2 divided by this value is equal to E21. That is induced EMF in the second antenna. Okay. So here E2 is common. Here E2 is a common term. We can take it outside. I2. So take it outside as I2. So I2 of this term minus Zm squared, that is equal to E21. Next we are going to multiply this term with this. Okay. So we can get the values like this. Z11, Z22 plus Z11, Zm. Next Z22, Zm plus Zm squared minus Zm squared. So Zm squared, Zm squared cancel each other. Correct? It is plus, it is minus. So here, next, in this one, Zm is common. We can take it outside. Then it becomes Z11 plus Z22. Okay? So next step, we are going to find out this I2 from this equation. So I2 is equal to, we can move this term to this right hand side. So it goes in the reverse order. We can get E21 into Z11 plus Zm divided by Z, this term goes to this denominator. So Z11, Z22 plus Zm of Z11 plus Z22. Consider this as the fourth equation. So we have obtained I2 value in terms of induced EMF and its impedances. So now we are going to substitute this fourth equation in the third equation. Okay, this is the fourth equation. We are going to substitute this value in the third equation. So what is the third equation? That is nothing but I1. We have already derived, right? So I1 is equal to Zm I2 divided by Z11 plus Zm. This is the I1 value. That is third equation. We are going to substitute the value of I2 here. So this I2 is replaced by this expression. Now we have got Zm divided by Z11 plus Zm into that I2 is replaced like this, right? So in the next step, this value and this value get cancel each other. Then the current I1 is equal to E21 Zm divided by Z11 Z22 plus Zm of Z11 plus Z22. That is, the current in the first antenna, it's directly related with the induced EMF in the second antenna. So current I1 in terms of induced EMF in the second antenna. Okay, consider this as the fifth equation. Next, we are going to consider the second diagram where the input is given at the second antenna and the first antenna is open here. Okay, so at that time we are having the induced EMF E12 at the first antenna due to the current I2. Okay, so here again the same procedure we are going to follow. We are going to apply Kirchhoff's Mess law for this first loop as well as second loop. So we can get Z11, here is Z11 plus Zm into I1 minus Zm I2, that is equal to induced EMF, that is voltage. Okay, consider this is the sixth equation and this sign Z22 plus Zm into I2. Here it is I2 minus Zm into I1, that value is equal to 0. There is no voltage source. Okay, so now we have got two equations, 6 and 7. So from this seventh equation, we are going to obtain I2 value. So in this equation, we have to move this Zm into I1 to the right hand side as a plus value. So Z22 plus Zm into I2 is equal to Zm into I1. So from this, I2 is equal to what? Zm I1 divided by Z22 plus Zm. Consider this as the eighth equation. Okay. So now we are going to substitute this eighth equation in this sixth equation in order to obtain I1 value. Okay. Substitute this eighth equation in this sixth equation. That means here this I2 is replaced by this value. Okay. So what is the value of that? Here the sixth equation is what? Z11 plus Zm into I1 minus this Zm. This I2 is replaced by this eighth equation. So we can get Zm I1 by Z22 plus Zm, that is equal to E12. So then we can get Z11 plus Zm into I1 minus Zm square I1 divided by Z22 Zm is equal to E12. So then we are going to take the LCM. So this term is multiplied with this. So Z11 plus Zm into Z22 plus Zm into I1 minus Zm squared I1 is equal to E12. Then multiply these two terms. We can get this value. Then Zm squared and minus Zm squared cancel each other. We can get the values like this. I1 of Z11, Z22 plus here Zm is common. We can take it outside. So we can get Zm of Z11 plus Z22 divided by this term, that is equal to E12. So in the next step, we are going to move this term to this right hand side. We are going to find out the I1 value. So I1 is equal to E12 into Z22 plus Zm. This value comes to this denominator. We can write like this. Consider this as the ninth equation. We are going to substitute the value of this ninth equation in the eighth equation. So what is the eighth equation? Eighth equation is I2 is equal to Zm I1 divided by Z22 plus Zm. Correct. So in this one, this I1 value is replaced by this expression. Okay. So here we can write Zm divided by Z22 plus Zm into this I1 is replaced by E12 and the remaining terms. Okay. So here we can cancel this term as well as this term. Finally, we can get the current I2 is equal to E12 Zm divided by Z11 Z22 plus Zm Z11 plus Z22. Consider this as the 10th equation. If the current I1 is equal to I2, then the equations 5 and 10 both are equal. So this is the 5th equation and this is the 6th equation. That is, the current I1 depends on the induced EMF in the second antenna. The current in the second antenna depends on the induced EMF at the first antennum. That means this induced EMF is due to this current flows, right? So here, if I1 is equal to I2, we are going to equate these two terms. What will happen? All the terms are cancel each other except these two values. Okay, that means this E21 is equal to E12. From the reciprocity theorem, it can be proved that the properties of transmitting and receiving antenna exhibit the reciprocity properties. Reciprocity properties means what? Equality of directional patterns, equality of directivities, equality of antenna impedances. So we have proved the reciprocity theorem.